Welcome to the Academy of Photography. When the aliens come, we still deserve to shoot. I'm Christian Tudor, and today I would like to talk about my second favorite lens, 72-200 from Canon, EF f2.8. Why I want to talk about this is because this is my second favorite lens after the 24-70. This is the most useful lens if you want to shoot from a distance. Completes the range from wide lens to the narrow telephoto. I cannot picture me doing my work as a photographer on the field, doing portraiture, doing weddings, or doing anything without this lens. This is always on my shoulder. This is always on my second camera. And if I do a special shoot, for example, of portraiture shoot outside, definitely this will be my main camera. So I'm not gonna go through the technical jibber jabber. You can find technical stuff everywhere online. A lot of other people are picking up the brochure and they're gonna read you the technical stuff. I don't really want to care how many spherical and aspherical lenses are inside, how many blades and all of that crap. I'm gonna talk about only the essence and only when I believe this is useful for. And the advantages of disadvantages of this lens. This is not the most perfect lens in the world, but it's a very good lens, and I'm gonna show you why. Just a quick overview. It is a pretty big lens, very impressive. It is quite heavy, and it comes with the hood, and this will be even more impressive. It comes with the ring for the tripod. A very interesting and very good feature about this lens, it is a zoom lens from 72-200, but everything happens inside, unlike the 24-70, which the lens extends. So it is weatherproof, dustproof, build quality like Canon. All the lenses are very good quality. It feels very good in your hand with a 77 millimeter diameter. And I recommend for any lens to use one of these cheapies from eBay just for protection, nothing else. If you want to put some fancy filters, feel free to do so, but definitely a simple UV filter will actually do the job. Just protect the lens. You do not want to scratch the lens. Okay, moving on. Automatic focus and manual focus, and also a button which limits the focus range between 1.5 meters to infinity and 3 meters to infinity. So it does have the focal distance ring and the focus ring. It does focus very fast, and the best advantage of this lens, you can shoot from a distance, you can have nice candid portraits. This is a distance lens. I do not recommend this one if you are shooting inside in small spaces. This is for distance. The reason I have picked this one is the 2.8 is very important for me as an all-around photographer. If I'm in a low light situation, the 2.8 will definitely do the job. Increasing the ISO will give me portraits from a distance. This is an absolute must for any serious photographer. I'm just gonna mount it on my camera and show you how I use it. Okay, now this, it's a pretty big camera. And it does impress, as mentioned before, looks are very important. People come to me and they are always picking up on my cameras. They seem to be amazed about the size of the cameras. As I have showed in other videos, if I do a wedding, I can go in different places and different corners. Nobody sees that I'm shooting, and I can shoot over people's shoulders and I can take the nice candid shots. People are very happy with them. Just wanted to show you how I use it as a second camera on one of these very comfortable straps. We're gonna talk about straps in a different tutorial. And I connect the strap here, not on the camera, just to make sure. This is like that, next to my body, and this is how I walk. Bang, 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 from every corner. It gives me the freedom not to need an assistant, and gives me the instant ability to take a different perspective than the main camera, which is again a 24-70, and I can go into corners. I can shoot from a distance, from actually a large distance, 20 to 30 meters, you're still okay. And this will give me absolutely the nice blurry portraits, the candid shots with the blurry background that everyone is after. One of the disadvantages of this is it's not as sharp as you would think. It does reach the sharpness, but I can tell you from my experience that I need to take three to five shots to get the sharp portrait that I wanna take. Now I'm talking about external conditions, I'm not talking about studio conditions. If I'm outside and I move, I need to shoot more than the other camera in order to get the sharpness. Why? I don't know why, because I'm not a lens manufacturer, but in comparison with the 24-70 or other prime lenses, it's not as sharp as you would hope so, even for the price tag, even for the fact it's an L series lens with the red ring and it's white, so it's supposed to be sharp, but again, it takes a bit of effort to get the sharpness you would want as a professional photographer. Now I can understand why Canon released also the image stabilization version. It's double in price, and definitely the image stabilization will ensure you get a sharp portrait easier. For its price range, I would definitely take it into consideration as your second shooter if you do weddings or if you do events. Without further comments, this is a good product and you should consider this lens if you are in the market for a telephoto lens. If you want to find out some very good deals about this lens, just jump on the Academy of Photography's website. Go into the equipment review section, you'll definitely find my review on this lens. I hope you enjoyed this video, and holes bolas portocolas. Until I see you next time, I wish you happy shooting. Thank you very much.